Yeah. Hi, boys and girls. Welcome to your new school year. This is a video that will talk to your parents and you about some important things this year. So follow along. My name is Lisa McCaffrey. I'll be your first grade teacher. I'm starting my ninth year here at Clarne Lakes, and I'm so blessed to be a leprechaun. It's a wonderful school. I'd like to tell you a little bit about my family. My husband's name is Terry. He'll come into the classroom. In fact, he was a pilot once, so he'll bring his helmet and all his gear and talk to you about how fun it was to fly airplanes. I also have a son who's married. His name is Garrett. His wife is named Holly. They live in Atlanta, and they have my first grandbaby daughter. Her name is Quinn. You'll hear all about Quinn. Love being a grandma. And then I have a son, Trevor, who lives here in Tallahassee and works here. And then I have a wonderful daughter who is at Childs High School. She is a junior, and she rides horses. That's a picture of her on her horse, Destiny. She jumps for her sport, and sometimes you'll see pictures of her. I'll go on the weekends and come back and tell you about how our weekend we're watching her jump. Anyway, I love school, I love reading, and I love students. So let's see what's going to happen next in our classroom. We're going to stick with our same school motto, soaring high to new heights. And we are going to soar in first grade. You're going to learn to read chapter books. You're going to learn to do your math facts. It's just going to be a fabulous year. Remember our school rules to keep learning every second by being respectful, responsible, and ready to learn. You'll have your daily red folder. It looks like this. And that is for our teacher and parent communication. It will go home every day, and it comes back to school the next day. When you get home at night, you'll open it up, and you'll take out things that need to be filled out by a parent, and they'll be in the box of return to school. In the other side will be things to keep at home. Those are papers your parent can keep at home. On the back will be behavior updates. It will show what color you were on during the day and if there were any codes given. There's also a place to record how many minutes you read and for your mom or dad to sign it every night. And then you'll bring it back the next day. If you're going to send notes to me, parents, it's the best way to send them. Put them in the red folder so your child can give it to me right when they get to school. Really important about transportation. I want all our friends to get home safely. So if there are any changes in your child's daily transportation, please send an email, a note, or call the school to let us know. Remember, we start dismissing and packing up about 2:40, so please give us as much advance notice as you can so I get your child to the right spot. Whenever you send notes to school that go to the front office, please be sure to include the date, my name, and your child's name. That way that communication can go to the office. Some important reminders. First of all, sign up for Listserv. It's the best way to stay communicated with the school. They post things about PTO events. They talk about safety measures, if there's any important announcements. So be sure you are on the Listserv. That's an email system that they send out to parents. If you're not on it, please call the front office and inquire about how to get on it. Don't forget to stay up to date on the master calendar. It's found on their school website. It has all the latest information on things happening. We'd also like you to leave a change of clothes in your child's backpack. That way, if there are any reason at all that they need to change their clothes during the day, they'll have a change handy. Our behavior plan will go green, yellow, red. Green means the child followed the rules, wonderful day. Yellow means needed to be redirected more than once or twice about the same issue. They're not on yellow unless I've had to address it a few times that day. Red, the student needed additional redirection. A major offense like hitting or destroying property. The consequences are as follows. If your child's on yellow, there will be a code on the back. The codes are explained at the bottom of the red folder. That means I've had to talk to them. I've asked them why they were on yellow, and they go home knowing. So when your child comes home, you can ask them to explain what happened. I won't need to talk to you about it. If they are on red, I will contact you, and if you want more directions on that, you can contact me. Homework expectations, 20 minutes of reading each night. Be sure to record that on the back of your child's folder. First grade reading scale, A's, B's, C's, and N's. The percentages are there. Your child must pass 100% of the benchmarks. That doesn't mean they have to get a 100 on every sheet. It means that they have to have a 70% or higher to be successful in first grade on benchmarks. We'll explain that more at conferences. Speaking of conferences, those will be held Zoom this year. We do a conference with every family in first grade the first 9 weeks. Snack and water bottles. Please be sure to send a healthy snack with your child each day. It needs to be a snack that they can open on their own and eat on their own. I really encourage you not to send something that has a dip or something that needs a spoon or fork. We don't have those extra materials in the classroom. They'll also be eating it while they're working on their seat work. So it needs to be something like crackers or cheese or fruit that they can pull out of a bag and just enjoy while they're working. Water bottles are very important. If you send a water bottle with a screw lid, sometimes it doesn't get on tight and the water bottle falls over and then gets everything on the desk wet. It can ruin books, laptops, papers. So I'd like to encourage you to take a look at the picture and find a water bottle with a pop tap that they can just open, take a drink, and close easily. So what should you practice before coming to school? Wearing your mask. Friends, look at this funny doggy. There's three ways we don't wear our mask and one appropriate way. He needs to wear it over his nose and mouth, just like you do. Practice your hand washing and your social distancing. We'll learn all about that the first few days. When you arrive at school, somebody will take your temperature, either at car drop-off or in front of the school building or in the classroom. It's just a forehead thing, nothing in your mouth. It's very easy, just to make sure everybody's feeling their best. We're going to move around the classroom only when asked by a teacher. We're not going to have our masks on because we're 6 feet apart. You'll see that in the video. But if people are up and walking about or I'm walking around, we will put our masks on. We'll have our masks on when we're in the hallway, but we'll make sure we have lots of mask breaks during the day. We'll also wash our hands a lot and clean off our desks a lot. So important notes, this is different than last year. If your child arrives between 7:45 and 8 a.m., they're to go to the media center. If your child arrives between 8 and 8:25 a.m., they're to go to the classroom. That way there's nobody on the playground first thing in the morning. There's no lunch bunch this year. We'll miss our parents coming in to eat with our friends. There's also no dropping off lunch, special lunches. Free lunch will be provided to all students this year. If you want to bring your lunch, that's perfectly fine. But if your family forgets their lunch or they'd like something special, I'm sorry, this year you cannot drop that off. We want to limit the number of items brought from home. Our backpacks will be staying close to our desks. So please do not include toys, playground items, stuffed animals, anything in your backpacks, friends. Clean them out. Your backpacks for your lunchbox, your snack, your water bottle, your red folder, things like that. Unfortunately, we cannot have volunteers on campus this year, but I still need volunteers. Still need people that will cut things out at home if I send it. So please, if you're able to volunteer from home, answer that question on the survey, or if you missed that, just send me an email. Remember, masks are required when we're not far apart. So our Digital Academy children will be part of our class. They will be logging on via Zoom for different lessons during the day. The teacher, I will record attendance every day, so it's very important that you let me know you're there. Some things we'll have live, and some things we'll have a pre-recorded instruction. Sometimes we'll have a small group, and sometimes you'll just work from home on assignments in your modules. You are expected to complete the assignments that are determined by me, and you must do your own work. No having your older brother and sister do it, or mom and dad. You have to work hard, even though you're at home.
Hi, boys and girls. I'm Mrs. McCaffrey. Welcome to my class. We're going to start out front here, where you might come up with your mom and dad as they drop you off. Two things you need to do. Number one, be really brave. Number two, give them a hug and a kiss. Make sure you have your mask on like I do. And then you'll walk through this gate. I'm going to show you how to get to our classroom. You're going to be walking with other children, and hopefully mom or dad will put a tag on you that says McCaffrey, so that if you get lost and you don't know your teacher's name, you can just point to it. There'll be a lot of staff members out here helping you, so if you get lost, just ask a grown-up. So come with me and we'll go to our classroom. Is not ours, but the second door says Mrs. McCaffrey, and I'll be standing with the door open waiting for you to come inside. So if you get dropped off at car drop-off by mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, you'll go down, straight down the hallway. Once again, you should have a tag on that says McCaffrey in case you would get lost and someone needs to know your teacher's name. And here's where you'll see my name, Mrs. McCaffrey. Let's go inside. Still getting ready for you, so it doesn't look perfect. But look at our desks. They're all spread apart. That way you don't have to wear your mask all the time. Beside your desk, you'll have a basket for all of your goodies. There's already some special things in there for you. We have books to read. We have a birthday wall. I can't wait to see when your birthday is. We have the Lost Tooth Club. How exciting, when you lose a tooth, you get to put a sticker up. We have a bathroom, two sinks, lots of goodies in here for you. So I'll look forward to seeing you on August 31st. Wear your mask. Bye-bye.